you. And thank you for accepting the presentation. We have a study where we are using carefully selected markers, so we are not using 16,000 markers, but fewer. The focus of this presentation is how to report the latest results if you are actually having a case group. We have been using the panel from the scientific or precision like an astral panel, which contains 164 steps, and it's a combination of the settlement panel and the 10K panel. And we are very much in favor of using light equation, as some of you know if you have been to the forensic reasoning workshop. Using the panel from the scientific or precision like an astral panel, which contains 164 steps, and it's a combination of the settlement panel and the tankage investigations and other kinds of investigations you can combine light ratios. To calculate light ratios, we need a few frequencies. And to get the frequencies, we need reliable population data ratios. And that is one of the main issues here, to get reliable results from different populations from all over the world. So we have decided that to have a reliable population reference database, we need all individuals to be typed the same markers. So the same individual should be typed for all markers and growth panels. And we also need a certain size of the database to have good results. So we dig into the data online and publish the data and try to select the database we use in our study. So we needed, as I already mentioned, that same individuals would type both panels. And we found that the database size, the sample size of the database should be at least 75 individuals. After selecting those, we tested whether we could distinguish these populations from all these samples from each other. So we did homogeneity tests on databases, and we ended up with 8 meter populations. And you see we have here the European sample, all the yellow dots are the locations from the population database that is converting to our data, European data population. We have Greenland, we have North Africa, Southwest Asia, close to the Middle East, East Asia, South Central Asia, Sub-Saharan Africa, and Somalia. We have made a PCA plot, you see the cluster. Well, this is kind of a guess, but you see the last structure of this database that is converging to our data, European data population. We have Greenland, we have North Africa, Southwest Asia, close to the Middle East, East Asia, South Central Asia, Sub-Saharan Africa, and Somalia. We have made a PCA plot, you see the cluster. Well, this is kind of a guess, but you see the last structure of this database that is converging to these light integration calculations. So we did light calculation for a certain individual profile to find the probability of finding a profile like that in each population or subpopulation. A simple light integration calculation. And we know that we should be a little bit humble about this. Cross-population reference bases at present at least are certainly not perfect. Many populations that are included in our panel of subpopulations, and many populations are unsampled. We have a Pakistani sample of 120 individuals from a population of 200 million people. So of course, you risk to have a lot of sampling error. And also, the genome geographic origin of a person is often self-declared. And I don't know, I'm asked if I, from where I come, say, well, at least for the last 2-3 generations that I know of, I'm Northern European, but I don't know if it was a native man or somebody else that passing by that house at a certain time in my evolutionary history. So I would call myself European, but I actually haven't tested my genes. So we also need to be aware of that. There are some things that you should be aware of in population databases. Then you should also know, probably everyone here knows, that these markers that we use for ancestry informative studies are not diagnostic markers. There are the frequency based, which means that we could say this is just a constructed example. You see, if you have a type, it would be more often found in sub-Saharan Africa than in Europe or Asia, but you do find an AA in Europe or in Asia, etc. So these are all based on frequencies. In order to make this likely calculation between these eight major populations, we want to know if the sample that we have investigated comes from a person where we have what we call true population meta population in our handle of databases. And to do that, we have made a test called for population in database score. We have done that by raising the statistical method of the university. And it's a set score, so we calculate a set value and test it between different set of populations. In this case, the sample is here, it's forming between all these meta populations. So we would replace score. We have done that by a particular set because the risk of not having a proper population database is simply too high. So we may just make a calculation at random. So we would skip doing that calculation. We have tested the strength of these population database score and all the green dots in the right population. All the blue scores said, well, you don't have the correct subpopulation, which is actually true. You see all these. If you go back to where we have these best populations, we have no one from Latin America or America, we have from this part of the world. So it's not strange to these populations from Americans or from these populations from Brazil, are rejected as being part of this true subpopulation we have. So we then have the term that we have what we call the true population within our family of populations. We have the likely ratio, and there's also constructed software doing that for human geographer, and finding that this sum is really available. And thus both calculations for population database, this set score, and also do the likely ratio. And you're able to upload your own databases as well. There are limitations of this method, as many other people here have stated. If we have a mixture or mixed populations, we have problems. We had a case where a baby was found in a parking lot and a random baby, and the profile was tested to be 10,000 times more likely if it came from a person from a Somali origin than from any of the other several subpopulations we have in our panel. But sure, this baby was actually a mixed origin from European mother, something from African father, which is not so strange with this result because Somalis are thought to be kind of a mixed population between Arab, Middle East people and Sub-Saharan African. We had one successful case, which is probably one of the case. We tested this panel of markers from the mummy from the Alps, and he lived around 5,000 years ago, and probably was killed by stabbing, so this is actually the crime case. He was found in the Westside in the Alps in 1991, and the age profile is publicly available. And we found out that the highest likely ratio of human geographic origin was in northern Italy, which is pretty good because that's where he's now and then you see. We need to do further studies to kind of improve this method. So we want to add more markers that are capable of distinguishing the populations between Europe, Northern Europe, Southern Europe, Middle East, North Africa. And we also want to be able to better distinguish between people of Greenlandic origin and East Asian origin. So we need to add more markers. And also to get more accurate calculations, we want investigate how we identify mixtures, or mixtures, and how to handle those. So this is the place where it is now. We are actually doing these calculations, and we are trying to be humble about it, and not kind of overrating the weight of this evidence. And I want to thank especially Peter Smith, who made all this work, and just presented Vanya and